How's it going, guys? My name is Raw, and today what I'm excited to bring you is a new ranking system that is going to be in place into Gears of War 4. Now, guys, there's plenty of games that have breached into this kind of style, and it's called the ELO ranking system. Now, guys, I'm really excited to explain this to you if you don't know what this is, and I'm also excited to show you some pictures and some examples of what it could be like, okay? So, now, a lot of you might know of one already, and this was back in the Gears of War 2 days when Title Update 2 was out. Now, as you can see on the screen, we had 5 ranks. Now, guys, this was true, and this was really, really fun. It did take a lot of time to get to rank 5 because it took a lot of skill, and it is not easy, and you had to get there by playing well. So back in Gears of War 2, guys, in its prime, in its Title Update 2, the Gears of War Community Manager 6LK decided to put this in with the Microsoft True Skill, and it was based on the ELO rating system. Now, guys, ranks were calculated not by skill or points or kills. It was actually the rank determined by the wins and losses and whether you actually were favoured to win. So if you came across, like, 5 player 3s or rank 3s and your team was, like, obviously rank 4s, you would be the favourite to win. So if these rank 3s managed to beat you, after a couple more games, if they managed to keep on winning, they would progress up to a rank 4. So then vice versa, obviously if you were obviously your rank 4s and you were playing the rank 5s, that means if you managed to beat them, after a few more games of keep on winning and keep on progressing, you would now come to a rank 5. But guys, this is very easy to understand. I mean, this is a lot of skill. It's based on true skill points. The more wins and the more like losses that you don't get, the more that you'll rank up and more chance that you'll get to the highest rank. But then obviously, each time you're playing and each time you're ranking up, you're going to be playing people at the same skill level or roughly the same skill level, so it's going to get harder each time. So guys, if you don't know what this is on the screen right now, this is CSGO ranking. And guys, this is kind of different to the Gears of War style. You can see here that there is 18 ranks, but at the start, you don't even have a rank. And what you need to do is basically build yourself up by playing 10 matches on competitive, and then it's going to base you on your kills, your teamwork, your wins and losses, and then put you at a rough like kind of scale. So if you win all 10 games, you could jump probably straight to Gold Nova 4 without even like worrying, which would be really good, and that's your halfway to your ranking already. And if you've got good teammates, you can work on that and you can build yourself right up to the global elite. But guys, regarding Gears of War 4, the Halo 5 is going to be kind of similar to Gears of War 4. Now, I'm going to explain how, and this has been told by me, but I cannot say by who, but I can tell you that there's a guy that I know that knows someone that is playing the beta and testing it for the beta for us to test, because he works with obviously the Collision and all that kind of stuff. So this is really good news, guys. Now we can see here there's a bronze, silver, gold, platinum and diamond rank, but then there's also 6 different parts and tiers inside each like class. So what we could be seeing in Gears of War 4 is we're going to be having like a rank system like this, and that basically each time you play you're going to get points, and each time you get points you move up a tier. So say the first tier you need like 25 points, and then the second tier in bronze is you need 50 points, then vice versa, obviously 75, 100, and then maybe 250, and then 500. And then if you get more than 500, you move into the silver style. So guys, I think that's what it's going to be like, which is going to be awesome. And I'm really looking forward to trying this out and giving all this new people new experiences, because this is one of the most successful ways of a game and how to get people to play your game, because it's like a never ending. You can just keep playing, keep grinding and keep going and get that best rank. But guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you did enjoy this. I did try my best to explain the ELO system as good as I could. So guys, if you did enjoy this video and you did find it interesting, hopefully you want more Gears of War 4 videos, hit that like button, subscribe, and I will definitely be posting much more videos in Gears of War 4 very soon. But guys, thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed. Peace.